Okay, again, sorry. Okay, we'll proceed with the learning of verbs. So last week we did mention and we did discuss on the topic of a three-letter verb, on how this three-letter verb works. So we learn from the fa'ala form first. Fa, we have to understand where is the position of fa fi'il. We have to understand where is the position of ain fi'il, and then we have to understand where is the position of lam fi'il. Okay, and I have explained on our last session why this is so important, because it relate to all the other verbs. So last session we did mention that fa'ala form is the wazan. Other than fa'ala is called as mauzun. Am I right? So we have fataha, right? Just a revision, quick revision. Fataha is the fa fi'il, ta is the ain fi'il, ha is the lam fi'il. Then we have do, ro, ba. The huruf do, the alphabet do is the fa fi'il, and the ro is the ain fi'il, and the ba is the lam fi'il. So this is one way that we can tackle and understand the meaning of all this fa fi'il, ain fi'il, lam fi'il. In fact, last week we did discuss a bit on how it's relatable, right? Why this fa fi'il, ain fi'il, lam fi'il is so important. We did mention a bit last week on the part where when it go up to when it's being tasrif to all the 14 wazan. Huwa huma hum, hiya huma hunna, anta antuma antum, anti antuma antunna, ana nahnu. So when it go up to all these wazan, then you see the changes to the pattern. Okay, so from here you can see, sorry, huwa, I think you can refer to the kitab also. If I say here the screen never come up. Okay, huwa, and we have fa'ala, we have the page 4. Huwa, we have fa'ala, then huma, fa'ala, and then hum, we have fa'alu, then hiya, we have fa'alat, huma, we have fa'alata. Again, this one, last week I did mention, please make your amendments. Okay, it's supposed to be ta with a mat. Okay, it's supposed to be fa'alata, fa'alata. Okay, you all can make amendments on that part. Then the next wazan we have hunna. Okay, then we have anta, it is fa'alta. The antuma, we have fa'altuma. Antum, we have fa'altum. Anti, we have fa'alti. Antuma, we have fa'altuma. Antunna, we have fa'altunna. Ana, fa'altu. Nahnu, fa'alna. Okay, the pattern here is very straightforward. That's why you can see for yourself. Okay, then we move to the pump diagram, which is at page 5. So pump diagram, in fact last week I did share with you all, that you all have to memorize. So how manage to memorize or having difficulties to memorize? So if I ask to close the book right now, you all can see out the wazan. That should be the objective, right? I think you ask like Uncle Zubid all lah. Last time when they learn also same. Close the book. Okay, give me all the 14 wazan. Cannot run already. So we give it a try. You all can close, right? And you all can refer. Okay, we start with here, right? Without looking. You all can start with this again. Huwa. We start with huwa. We have fa'ala, then fa'ala, fa'alu, and then here fa'alat, and here we have fa'alata, and here we have fa'alna, and here we have fa'alta, and here we have fa'altuma, and here we have fa'altum. Nahya fa'alti, fa'altuma, fa'altun, fa'altu, fa'alna. Okay, good. Okay, practice make perfect. Ya. Just keep on practice. No, don't worry. Then we go a bit in depth on the topic of huruf ziyadah. Huruf ziyadah have a very great relation to fi'il, to the study of fi'il madi. We are at page 6. Okay. So huruf ziyadah, here we have the page 6, we have sa'altumuniha. Okay, we have sin, hamzah, lam, ta, mim, waw, nun, ya, ha. Okay, we have discussed this also on the last session. In fact, last session we go in quite a great detail on the explanation on how to identify huruf ziyadah in verbs. Okay, so we have dharaba. It resembles the fa fi'il, a'in fi'il, am fi'il from fa'ala, right? So here you can look side by side. You can look through, because we're going to study daraba and fa'ala together, because they start together with the same wazan, huwa, go up to huma, hum, and all the way to ana and nahnu. Am I right to say that? So last week we did mention, and we did go through on fa'ala. This is the huma form. So this is, we go up to the huma form. Huma form. Fa'ala means they both did. Daraba, that means they both beat. Okay. So again, with the method of fa'ain lam fi'il, we have the alif as the huruf ziyadah. Same. We have ba, ra, ba here. Then we have the alif as the huruf ziyadah. Okay? Okay. Last week, we only go through the huruf ziyadah, which is the alif. In fact, I will try to explain slowly. For all this huruf ziyadah, right? For all this huruf ziyadah, it has a specific name for it. Like when we learn tajwid, a different mat have a specific name for the different kinds of ruling of mat, huruf mat. Same, this huruf ziyadah have a specific name. So just to add on, now you can write down also this huruf ziyadah alif on the domir of huma. Okay, again, this huruf ziyadah alif on the domir of huma male. Okay. On the domain of huma male, this alif is called aliful ithnin. Aliful ithnain. Okay, aliful ithnain means alif that represent two male, that is the third person, I put third person, two male. Ithnain means two. Ithnain means what? Two. So aliful ithnain, alif that resemble two person. Two of what? Two male personnel. Understand? Okay. So get it? It's like playing maths lah. So it's fixed. Example, we have fataha. Okay. Here the same daraba, right? I give you fataha. Fataha. He open. Fataha means he open. He open fataha. So when it's to huma, we get what? What do we get? Fa ta ha, right? The ha is with a alif. Fa ta ha. Okay. So there's aliful isnin here. See? There's aliful isnin here. That represent two male, which is the third person. So the translation will be they both open. They both. Yeah? Same method. Fataha, daraba, same method. Fa is a fa fi'il, ta is a ain fi'il, ha is a lam fi'il. That is how you're going to approach verbs from now on. Okay? Next, we have home, right? We did mention home on our last session. Home, that means they all or they. So same, fa fi'il, cancel off, ain fi'il, cancel off, lam fi'il. And please take note on the lam fi'il, it has to be dhammah. See, like dharabu, the ba, which is the lam fi'il, will be at the state of dhammah. Okay, so that's the pattern for home. But here, the huruf ziyadah is waw and alif. See that? Waw and alif. Same goes with dharabu, waw and alif. If I have fataha, so it become what? Fatahu, very good. Fatahu. Okay? So same. Cancel off fa, ain fi'il, lam fi'il. So you have waw and alif here. So this waw and alif, right? We start with waw first. Waw, eh? Number one, we have waw, which is the huruf ziyadah. Waw has a meaning also. Has a meaning, has a name, specific name for it. Like how aliful is name, the previous one, the hum, sorry, the huma, right? Have a specific meaning and a name for it, which is alif that resembles and represent two male, which is the third person. Same goes to this waw. This waw has its name, which is called wawul jama'. Wawul jama'. Wawul jama'. Waw jama' means waw. Okay, I write here. Waw that shows plural for male. Waw that shows plural for male. For this case, because waw jama', inshallah, when we learn isim, also waw jama' occur in isim. That is for jama' muzakkar salim, but I don't want to go into that. But now, this waw, when it's connected to verb, right, it represents waw that shows plural form or plural for male third person. Third person. Okay? Because the translation will be they. They all. They all did. They all open. Am I right to say that? Okay. So that this waw has a name. So waw jama'. Jama' means also comes from the word jama'ah. Jama'ah means community, right? You pray in jama'ah. So jama' is a form of congregation and community. So you take away the ta mabuta, you become jama' only. So jama' means plural, singular means mufrad, right? Then dual in Arabic is called muthanna. Jama' means plural. Okay, then we have this alif, right? This particular alif, this alif is called, and previously for huma we have learned aliful isnin. alif that that represents two male, which is a third person. But this is not aliful isnin. Okay, this is called aliful tafriq. Aliful tafriq. Aliful tafriq. Okay, again, you might ask, wah, like that, I have to, how to recognize aliful isnin, how to recognize aliful tafriq, right? So, aliful isnin only occur in the wazan of huma, mil. Aliful tafriq only occurs, and you can only see aliful tafriq in the wazan of hum. Wazan of hum, right? After waw, not before. After waw jama', after waw jama', then you can see aliful tafriq. Okay, I'm going to show you a bit of the definition of this. Okay, for let's say example, we have fatahu, fatahu, say fataha. So fataha is the original fa fa'in ain fa'in lam fa'in. Then we have fatahu. Fatahu, am I right to say this? They open. Fatahu. Okay, straightforward. So you know that the huruf ziyadah, after cancelling all this fa fa ain fa lam fa, you know the huruf ziyadah will be waw and alif. Okay, so you might ask, literally this waw is counted in the vowel of sukun. Am I right to say this? Fatahu. So if you learn tajwid, you only prolong this waw at least two harakat lah, at least two harakat. We prolong to this waw two harakat, fatahu. Okay, then the next question will be, so what's the reason and what's the rationale of this alif being here? Am I right to say that? So if it doesn't serve any vowels, eh? Because this alif have no vowels at all. At least waw serve a purpose. It has a sukun. Waw that is in a sukun state that prolongs the pronunciation of hu. Am I right to say that? Okay. But for this alif doesn't have any baris, or doesn't have any vowels. So how are we going to elaborate on this? Okay, go back to the meaning. Okay, we go back to the meaning. Aliful tafriq. Aliful tafriq. Alif that shows the difference of wazan. Alif that shows the difference of wazan. Tafriq means differences. Difference. To differentiate. Alif that differentiate, right? So you might think, differentiate what? What does it need to differentiate? Right? Okay, am I your right first? Because it has a relative meaning to it. So go back to this alif, okay. So you might think this alif doesn't serve any purpose. Okay, never mind. Then we will see other forms of example. Then you can see just in a aspect of a general perspective, not to go in great detail. Then you can see why this alif has to be there. If not, you get more confused. Okay, we have a verb which, this is a verb, ghaza. Ghaza means to go to war, right? To go to war. It's a, to fight in a war, means ghaza. Okay, so zai. We have learned the basic a bit. They must have fa fa'il, ain fa'il, lam fa'il, right? Here you see there's only two lafaz. Two lafaz. At least fa'ala, fa'ala, there's three, right? Fa'ala here, ghaza, that's it. But it's been prolonged by this alif. Okay, this we have not learned yet. This is very far for us. We are at the very beginning stage. But I'm trying to show you something why this alif should, alifu tafriq, have a very big significance in terms of differentiating the wazan of verbs. This is huwa. Huwa means he go to war. Ghaza. Okay. So as the initial part for ghaza, right? This is called fi'il naqis. Fi'il, not fi'il naqis, is the fi'il madi naqis wawi. Okay, just it's called naqis. Okay, it's called naqis wawi. Naqis wawi. Why? Because inside this alif there's a waw. I will explain later when we go on. Okay. So now example, we have the sort of part of this ghaza. When it go up to home, right? When it go up to home, it has the wazan of ghazaw. Okay, again, all this you need to learn first. I'm just trying to show you why this alifu tafriq is a difference. Sorry. You will not go to home, I think this one a bit. Okay, we'll go to the present tense. Present tense, we got yaghzu. Yaghzu, you see? So, again, you see here waw, right? You might think this waw is waw jama'ah, or waw jama', waw that shows plural form. No. Okay? Waw that shows plural form always comes after it is alifu tafriq. Okay, this is just a general thing I want to show you. This wazan yaghzu you haven't learned yet, so it's okay. It's okay if you don't understand. I'm just trying to show you the pattern. Okay, I think I write it nicely here. So we have fatahu, right? Then we have yaghzu. See? So this wazan here, this is a verb also. This wazan here has a waw. You might think that waw is a waw jama', this is not waw jama'. Okay? So I will not explain this waw resembles what, because we haven't reached to this stage yet. But this waw is not waw jama'. But for this waw, is waw jama'. Because the meaning here is home. Right? And here this meaning will be huwa. So this waw is waw jama'. So to differentiate this waw between this waw, it has to come this alif. Just to explain that. I just want to explain this part only. Why this alif has to be there. Our scholars mention it differentiate the wazan. And again, why? Why they have to come, not say why the scholars have to come the alif, because this alif has already been there in the Arabic language. Alifu tafriq, It has always been there, right? Especially in the Quran, or when the ancient Arabic, the knowledge of alifu tafriq has already been originated there. But this is the reason why we want to differentiate between these two wazan. Why? Because when you recite the kitabs of our scholars, right, the books of our scholars has no baris. That's one. So, and then when you recite the ancient Quran, the ancient Quran also got no vowels, but it has signs like this alif after waw. And alif after waw, it resembles what? Alifu tafriq. And alif after waw, right, always resembles alifu tafriq. That means if you really identify this as alifu tafriq, this is going to be what? Waw jama'. Am I right to say that? If you identify this firsthand, now you imagine there's no baris, right? There's no vowels. I'm just going to write this. There's no vowels, right? How are you going to recite this? Doribau or duribau, right? You have so many ways for you to recite it with your own assumption, right? But no. First of all, you have to recognize the wazan. You have to recognize the wazan. The wazan here have alif, right? Any alif that comes after waw is alif utafriq. That's for sure. Any alif that comes after waw for a verb, this is a verb. I'm not referring to noun. For a verb, any alif that comes after waw, right, for a verb, definitely this alif utafriq. If this is alif utafriq, this is waw jama'. If this waw jama', that means you know that is the home wazan. So that means dorobu. Mafhum. If not, you get confused like this. Imagine yagzu, I did not write the vowels. So you might get confused. You might think this is waw jama'. So yaghazu, ya gha zu. Is it appropriate? No, it's not appropriate. Because why? First of all, after waw there's no alif. This alif is not there. That's one. Furthermore, this is not a hum wazan. This is a huwa wazan. Okay, that's why the wazan become yaghzu. Yaghzu. And this is not for plural. This waw is not showing plural. This waw is showing the state of this verb. So again, no need to worry about yaghzu. This wazan yaghzu, we haven't learned yet. But I'm trying to show you why this alifu tafriq is so important to be included in the fi'il. It shows a very great significance, nah, alifu tafriq. Kan? Can understand?
This alifu tafriq is tajwid.
No. Alifu tafriq is mainly more related to grammar.
So this is, if you read the Quran, the waw of alifu tafriq, is it home?
Sorry? Home, yeah, correct. Yes, that's home. After the waw with a sukun, there's alif, right? And the alif usually doesn't have any baris or doesn't have any vowels, right? That is aliful tafriq. Confirm. That is aliful tafriq. Yeah. Okay? Okay. So we move to the next one. The last session we stop, right? Where do we stop? This one, right? Okay. Then we go to fa'alat. Okay, fa'alat, there's a ta sukun here. So same concept. Kaifa fa'il, ain fa'il, lam fa'il, we have a ta with sukun. Same darabat, da fa fa'il, ra ain fa'il, ba lam fa'il, we have a ta with sukun. So the ta with sukun is the huruf ziyadah, and this ta with sukun has a name for it also. Again, every huruf ziyadah has a name. This ta'ul sukun is called ta'ul ta'nith. Ta'ul ta'nith as-sakina. Ta'ul ta'nith as-sakina. That means ta that resembles a feminine state. Okay, I will write the English. Ta that represent feminine state. Here, feminine state, it refers to third P. Third P, that means, you know what, third person. That has a sukun vowel. Okay? That has a sukun vowel, that means, has a sukun, that means, has a sukun here lah. See the sukun? So that's the reason why it's called ta utta nithi asakinati. So to make it simple, ta utta nith asakina. Again, so example, if you have a verb fataha, fataha means he open. For this is under the wazan of hiya. Hiya means she. So darabat, she beat. Fatahat means she open. Understand? Can I? Can delete? So it's very fixed. It's very fixed. Right? She open. She walk. She eat. She drinks. Right? Behind. If it's a fi'il madi, yeah. If it's a past tense, behind it, it has to be a ta with a sukun. Ta utta'nith asakina. Okay? Can relate, eh? On this part, you all can relate. Okay? Okay, sorry. You're right first. Okay. Next, we have darabata and fa'alata. Fa fi'il, right? Same. Fa fi'il, ain fi'il, lam fi'il. Daraba, fa fi'il, ain fi'il, lam fi'il. So we have ta. Ta bi fatha and alif is huruf ziyada. That means ta with a fatha. Fatha is this baris or this vowel and alif. Okay, so here we have two huruf ziyadah. Here our scholars mention this ta represent two this ta, right, represent two huruf. The first huruf is ta, the second huruf is alif. Okay, so let's go to the green board and we see. Example, we have fatahata, fatahata. So we have ta and alif here, right? This is all the fa fi'il, ain fi'il, lam fi'il. So okay, this break into two. Sorry, break into two alphabets. The first alphabet is ta, right? The first alphabet is ta. This ta is called ta utta'nith. Ta utta'nith meaning ta that represents a feminine state. Feminine state. Like just now, ta utta'nith asakina, ta that represent a feminine state that has a vowel sukun, right? This is different. Same. Similar a bit. Similar actually, but without the sukun lah. Because why? The ta is with a fathah, right? The ta is with a fathah. So ta that represent a feminine state only, doesn't have a sukun. Okay? Then we have the alif, right? This alif is called aliful ithnin. Aliful ithnaini. If naini, that means alif that represent two person here. Again, this two person, we don't need to specify male or female. Why? This two person is not like the huma for, it's not like the huma for male. Huma for male, right? We have fataha, right? Fataha. Here we have fatahata. Can see the difference, right? If it's in fa'ala form. Fa'ala form will be fa'ala. For fatahata will be fa'alata. Okay, fa'alata. So there's a difference. This alif and this alif here, right, has a difference. This alif for huma, male, it represents two male, there is a third person. And it's still named aliful ithnain. Because why? Alif that represent two person. But two, what kind of two person that is valid for this huma? Is two person that is a male, that is third person, from a third person finger. That means they both. Okay? For this aliful ithnain, you don't need to specify two person for who? Male or female, you don't need. Because why? They already has this ta. Ta or ta'nith. Ta that represent feminine state. So you don't need to say that, oh, this alif, aliful ithnain represent two male. No. Then it will be contradicting to the translation. It will be contradicting to the translation because why? It comes with the ta first. Ta with the baris fathah. With the fathah vowel. Right? So with the fathah vowel, it represents that this is a ta u ta'nith. Ta that represent a feminine state. To determine the quantity, you go back to this alif. Aliful ithnain. Alif that represent two person. Okay? Two person of who? Two person of a female. So when you translate, they both female. Open. They both female did. They both female beat. They both female walk. Okay? Right, it's very straightforward. Okay? So we're going to be very slow and steady on this part. So okay, any question? Any question on this part? We will go very slow. No, don't worry. If I'm going very fast, please do stop me. Okay? Don't keep quiet. Because if you keep quiet, I have a assumption that I have an impression, not assumption. I have an impression that I thinking that, oh, you all, mashallah, like very memorized, very understand. No, if you all got any question, so you all can ask, can seek understanding. You know, because at this early stage is the best to ask actually. So when you go 10 lesson ahead, really, right? You want to ask on the lesson on this part is going to be very difficult, right? Because really you are deep into the to the language itself. So inshallah, we will stop here and then we will continue with the other wazan. So we have a few remaining wazan, like hunna, we have anta, antuma, antum, anti, antuma, antunna, ana, nahnu. So we're going to take it slow. Right, we're not going to rush. Okay, inshallah we will move to our tajwid.